So you know that ingredient that you bought for a recipe? You used a tablespoon of it, and now it haunts you every time you open the fridge. Today, we're making semolina and almond cookies. So I've got this orange blossom water. It's been in the fridge for quite a while. I haven't used very much of it, and I went looking for a recipe that I could use more of it. And unfortunately, you really only use this a teaspoon at a time. Here's what you're gonna need for these cookies. Semolina, almond flour, baking powder, salt, sugar, lemon, olive oil, eggs, orange blossom water, and icing sugar. So this is a cookie that apparently is from Morocco. And when I was researching it, some were made with almond flour and some were made with coconut flour or ground coconut. And I hate coconut, so I went with almond. And it's, you know, pretty standard cookie. First thing you do is you mix together all of your dry ingredients, get them incorporated. And then into the stand mixer, you put the sugar. And then you zest a lemon and put that zest into the stand mixer as well. And you use the beater and you beat that for quite some time. And the action of the sugar crystals grinding against the lemon zest really releases all of that oil and the aromatics. It smells fantastic. And then with the mixer still running, you drizzle in the olive oil. Next up, you beat in the eggs one at a time. As soon as one is fully beaten in, put in the next one. Then you mix in the orange blossom water. And I may never finish this bottle of orange blossom water. Now you slow the mixer down to low and you spoon in your dry ingredients a little bit at a time. As soon as it gets mixed in, another spoonful goes in. And this will get very stiff very quickly. The stand mixer had a little bit of trouble mixing it near the end. Once it's all mixed, use an ice cream scoop and scoop out about a tablespoon at a time, roll it between your hands, and then roll it in icing sugar. Put that onto a parchment lined baking sheet. And just before you put them in the oven, use your thumb and just sort of stamp the tops. Now, depending on your oven, that'll take 15, 16 minutes. You'll know they're done when they're golden brown on the bottom and they've got this really nice crackly texture on top. Pretty standard stuff. Let them cool on a rack and then enjoy them. So, that's what the cookie looks like. You really get a mixture of the lemon and the orange blossom water. The semolina gives it a kind of a gritty texture, which is quite nice. And it's not sweet at all. It's not like a chocolate chip cookie that is really sweet. I think this is meant to be eaten with a pot of really sweet tea. That's quite nice. That cookie's a winner.